ओके सो अरुजीत, लेट्स रिकॉर्ड योर फाइनल सिलेक्शन इन एमटेक इन आईआईटी पलक्कड जियोटेक एंड थैंक्स फॉर योर टाइम. ओके सो अरुजीत, आई नीड सम इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम योर साइड, लाइक फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर एंड व्हेन डिड यू ग्रेजुएट, व्हिच कॉलेज यू ग्रेजुएटेड, योर सीजीपीए, योर गेट स्कोर, दिस इंफॉर्मेशन एंड योर कैटेगरी. या
आई एम कमिंग फ्रॉम आलप्पुझा इन केरला. I graduated from Rajagiri in Ernakulam itself, in Kerala itself, as a KTU, under KTU. I got a CGPA of 8.64. And my GATE score was, I got graduated in 2020. Mm-hmm. And I got placed in an IT company, Cognizant. And I just worked for two to three months and just dropped it and prepared for GATE for 2 months and got a score of 573.
Okay, so you got 573. What is your category, Arujit?
General
category, 573 with civil engineering, right?
Yes.
Did you write with environment also?
Yeah, environment also, I read.
You wrote environment. So what was that score?
Score, I don't remember. My mark was 48.
Okay. So Arujit, then with this 8.6 CGPA, 573, did you apply for MS courses also?
No, I don't know. I haven't applied.
Okay, so you only applied for MTech and that too through COAP, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay. Now, Anujit, tell me which round you got. What did you get in different rounds of COAP?
Hello, where are you?
Yeah.
Okay. Which round?
You got in which round? In first round of COAP, second round COAP.
First, I got IIT Tirupati in round two. Mm-hmm. And then in round three, I got an IIT Palakkad.
Okay. So that you retained and then you finalized it.
Yeah, I retained and an order offer came and I finalized.
Okay. So now it is finally geotech in IIT Palakkad, right?
Yes.
Okay. So could you talk to some seniors over there, Anujit?
I have talked to them.
Okay. What did
they
say?
And they have told us that their faculty is very good. They are very friendly. Mm-hmm. And main faculty is in there has got doing lots of papers. Mm-hmm. So if you are interested in PhD and all, they can help a lot. Okay. And the academics is very good. Their teachers are very helpful, like that. They said.
Okay. And campus is also good, huh?
Okay. Now it is been working in a transit campus, but the campus and hostel facilities now they have is good.
Okay. Anujit, now tell me, you are also proceeding in CCMT. So, in different rounds of CCMT, what did you get so far?
Now only the first round has been completed and I got in MNIT.
MNIT Allahabad you got. And what did you get there?
Geotechnical engineering.
Geotech only you got. And that was your which choice?
Eighth
choice that you got.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so this geotech in IIT Palakkad and Motilal Nehru also you got IIT this geotech only. So yeah. Now can I ask you, Anujit, what you want to do after your masters? What is there in your mind?
Actually, I am not keen to getting in campus placement. If I go campus placement, I am happy. Yes, okay. I like to. I got a small interest in doing PhD. But okay. I don't know whether I am capable of doing it or not. So I guess during the first years of MTech, I should be getting more knowledge about the subject. And then I decide whether I want to proceed to PhD or not. Else, if I didn't get campus placement, I will move on to off-campus industries and all and get more training.
I tell you, for PhD, you know, you need to maintain very good CGPA, preferably 8.5 plus. The way you got in BTech, you need to have CGPA, good CGPA in MTech also. And other than CGPA, you need to have a good research area, which was not in BTech. In MTech, you need to have research area and maybe 2 to 3 research papers also. So if you get a good CGPA, good research area, good research papers in good journals, and some kind of software skill, like maybe MATLAB or Python, if you know, or something like software skill, where you are doing some kind of simulation or some kind of analytical models you're developing. So then I think your case for PhD is very strong, both in India as well as abroad. That is always there with you. So for that PhD, as you know, academics is very important. The research area is very important. Academics is very important. So I'm very sure you can do that. It's not difficult, but only thing is you have to put effort. That is something which is required. And I'm very sure you can do that. Okay, so anything else, Anujit, you want to tell? Because this video, maybe students will watch it. So anything you want to add, anything you want to tell, other information?
Nothing else.
Okay,
so,
yeah.
If I like to say something about the motivation, then yeah. I am a student actually. I think that gate is difficult to crack and I can crack it. So I may do my degree in some private college or in my state itself. But then I think then I should give it a try. Give it a 2 months of preparation and give it a try. And actually, after giving it a try, I understood that it is not that hard. It is not something important to crack. It's possible if you give it a try.
So just give your 100%, give your sincere effort. And if you give, as you said, 2 to 3 months you invested. So if some students are investing 5-6 months, then I think it is very much feasible and he can do that, right?
Anujit? Yeah, of course. If I can do it in 2 months, then everyone can do it.
Yeah, that's true. Simple. So how many marks did you get in civil engineering? How many marks?
50.
50 marks. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, then Anujit, thanks a lot. And once you join IIT Palakkad, I will again interact with you to know more about the course and IIT. Fine?
Yeah, fine.
Okay, thank you, Anujit.